What makes our herd stand out is we're 100% homebred. I was fortunate enough to have a good 4-H calf my very first year in 4-H, and it gave me the drive and willingness to breed from her and pursue a Master Breeder Shield. My grandfather became a member of the Holstein Association back in the late 1940s. He kept the herd purebred, and my parents, Ron and Ruth Ann, when they took over, they kept it purebred. We had never bought or purchased any animals, and I joined 4-H, and my very first 4-H calf was fairly successful, and that gave me the drive and the ambition to continue to breed from our home breeding and seed stock and develop the herd that we've got today, trying to do it on our own without purchasing anything. We prefer to sell to local breeders that like good cows and have the same vision as we do, and we'll continue to breed for them, and I wish everybody success for every cow that they buy. 18 to 20% of the points for our Master Breeder Shield come from cows that we have sold. 80% of the herd goes back to a cow that my mom and dad bred, Ellen Ben Shamrock. She was a double TN Arab, born in 1968. And I can remember milking her as a kid, and she was one of our best cows in the barn at that time. And I continued to breed from her, and I wanted to keep that family going. And it was my goal to have a very good or excellent and continue on till we can get 10, 11, 12, 13 generations very good or excellent.
Our daughters are very involved on a day-to-day basis on the farm. They're in the barn in the morning before they go to school, helping with chores, after school, weekends. We really couldn't do it without them, honestly. They're very hands-on. When I went back to work full-time, the girls started doing more of the paperwork side of things as well. So Kaylin and Regan do the registrations and the dairy trace reporting, proaction, preparation. The future looks good for them coming home and staying involved. I think being a homebred herd has really been a source of pride for the family. You know, everything that's standing in the barn is something we've created. Even down to 4-H with the kids, it's always kind of been our rule that you show what's in the barn. We don't buy things in, you know, to try and win the big prize. They work with what we've got, and it's taught them about winning and losing, right? One year you might have a good calf, one year you might have a not so good calf, but you appreciate the wins when you get them, because you know what it's like when maybe you're not at the top of the class. So it's just something we've always been very proud of, and you know, building that to that status and then getting the shield has really been something kind of a legacy for Terry. And hopefully, you know, he got one with his dad, and now he's got this one, and hopefully he can work towards another one with the kids.